You know, this time of the year, everyone talks about horror and how scary maybe these movies are, but you know what's really the truth? The truth is real horror, real American horror. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna show you and tell you stories about things that you're not even gonna believe that could be impossible. How about a man that took 33 minutes to hang? Does that sound creepy? It is if you're at the end of that rope. So come along. You're not even gonna believe where we're gonna go. Wow. Now that's real American horror right there. And that night on Christmas Eve, Earl took that tomahawk and chopped his wife and his baby to death. Earl Gardner that day looked up at those gallows and he knew he was about to meet his maker. Now, Earl that day was dressed in a new black suit because you know what? You want to look good for the hangman. Earl came out of this very door and waited to be sentenced. And the verdict ended up being death by hanging. The funny thing was, though, that Earl, he wanted to die. He even said, go grab a rope and get it over with. Go grab a rope and get it over with. And they knew that that rope was ready. You know, Sheriff Jordan got the word that the verdict was guilty. And what he was about to do was go downtown, and he wasn't going to go to the library. Hell no, he went where any self-respecting sheriff would go. He went straight to the bar. Now, Jordan gathered about three dozen men who had been drinking pretty heavily. So you can imagine what kind of a lynching party was going to ensue. Now you want to think that this case couldn't even have possibly happened, right? But it did. You can't even believe, and it was so horrific that it changed the course of history. You know, one thing about this case is it was federal, because if this would have been a county case, they wouldn't have hung him. But because it was federal, that allowed them the opportunity to be able to hang him. Death by hanging. They whisked Earl out of this side door into a waiting car. It's a creepy place. Never been to this dam. How many dams of this size do you come across and there's nobody here? Man, the way the wind's blowing and you just know that it's almost like there's spirits coming across this. Weird feeling. So they brought an Earl Gardner down below. So let's take a look into that rock quarry that's on the very bottom. And that's where they built the makeshift gallows. And I can only imagine between the drive here and then coming down there with three dozen men that Imagine what he felt like, you know? I mean, I wonder what he felt like in that day of his last day. You feel every moment on this bridge when you step down, you feel like it's going to crash in. It's the weirdest feeling for something that's so massive to feel so unstable. And I'm sure that's kind of like his life was, you know? His life was unstable. And every step he took, you know, he was unsure of himself. You know, he's sitting in the bottom of that dam in a car with a preacher for 5 hours. Now, I wonder if he wanted to be forgiven. You know, he killed 3 people in his life. And you know, he did an Apache death chant, maybe similar to the ones that they did in the Apache death cave. As they built the gallows and the fires that were going on and the drinking that was going on. And I'm sure that had to have been punishment itself. But the reality was, you know, he wasn't done. Gardner spent 5 hours in that car waiting for them to call his name. And when he got out of that car and went up to the gallows, which was makeshift, he was a smaller frame guy. So when he fell through that door, his shoulder got caught. And what that did was break his fall. And anybody who knows anything about hanging knows that the purpose of the rope is to break your neck. It didn't happen. Gardner was left dangling for 33 minutes. The sheriff finally walked over and put his foot on Gardner's shoulder and finished him off. And after that, there was never another hanging in the state of Arizona. That's the real horror of the Wild West. You know, when you're standing here and you're in a place that you feel like maybe you shouldn't be here, kind of get a creepy feeling. You know, experiences in life are kind of funny. So you think about right below this dam, right over here, let's take a look. The very bottom of this dam, one morning, 3 dozen men hung a man at the bottom of this dam. And not counting all the people that jumped off this. You think their souls are at rest? Or you think they're struggling? You know, if I had spent 33 minutes and it took somebody to put a big boot on my neck to kill me, I might just have a grudge. How about you, James? Do you have a grudge?
I'd have a grudge.
I'd come back.
Well, the sun's slowly starting to set on us here at Coolidge Dam.
You know, I think that's a good sign, James, that we get the hell out of here.
Yeah, it definitely takes on a creepier mood as we get the sun slowly going down over this mountain.
You know, you look at those cliffs and it's kind of like, you know, I feel a little like it's time to go, don't you?
Yeah, you start getting that I'm small feeling.
The dam don't feel like it's mush as much as it did when we first came here, but it's pretty much telling me it's time to go home.
Yeah, let's get out of here. Probably not a good place to hang out overnight. Go back to the Apache death cave or something where we feel more
safe. Feel more at home. This could be the Apache death cave here.